afternoon, everybody. Thanks a lot for having us over here. I'm from Arupa Mission Research Foundation. We are a 16-year-old organization. They say that pictures speak a thousand words. So we are presenting an animation film on child abuse. It's just a 5 minutes film. This is going to play in the background while I talk about our work. I'll just reduce the volume a little more. This is a film that's in local language. It's in Odia. It's been developed in Orissa, Bhubaneswar. And we use it as a training tool to talk to people, to talk to children, to talk to teachers, to talk to lawyers, to talk to media, and to talk to police, to talk to the community, to talk to other NGOs, to talk to the corporates about what impact child abuse has on the minds of children, and then how children carry it forward again later in their lives into their workspaces and their relationships, and the impact of it overall. Now, we cover everything over here in a very explicit manner. It talks about child discrimination. It talks about child labor. It talks about child neglect. It talks about physical abuse. It talks about emotional and psychological abuse. It also talks about verbal and sexual abuse. I've put it on mute because it's in Oriya, and mostly, I'm sure there'll be very few people who would understand the language. But we are trying to have it translated into different languages and then upscale our work in different states across different communities. Our target group for this animation, for this program that we call Seshav, is the transgender community and the children. We go to schools and parents mostly. And the objective of Seshav is empowerment of children, Sashaktikaran. So empowerment of children, and under empowerment of children, we deal with a number of subjects such as child survival, infant mortality rate, etc., comes under this, health issues, etc., and reproductive health of and maternal health care. Then we have child development, where we talk about education, as well as look into access to education, as well as providing tutorials and bridge schools and other such aspects where children can have access to education. We are under development. We also look into disaster management and response, where child abuse can be minimized in a disaster situation. Then we also look into child protection. We have the POSCO, the law on protection of child of children. So we talk about legal issues over there. And in a nutshell, we use this as an icebreaker to talk about abuse, which people are generally silent about. They don't want to talk about it. Maximum abuse happens at home. And this is something that people refuse to acknowledge. It could be a brother, it could be a sister, it could be anybody. And it happens in educated homes. It's not just, something that happens in rural areas, which is a misconception. And this is the message that we, try to carry out. And this is something that triggers negative development and impacts all other forms of development of people. So I'm open to any questions. This is what it is about. Our link with ICTs starts from 2002, where we were working with farmers on multimedia training program using touch screens on animal husbandry. We realized that visuals and animation films are a very good way of breaking into the minds of people, and therefore we came out with this animation film. And I would like to, I'm sure it's very clear. So this is the last part. So under the recent social development goals, where we talk about health, we talk about gender equality, we would request everybody to, even consider taking up child abuse as an education medium and to ensure holistic development of children and to reduce this menace in society. Thank you.